When North Carolina's largest severe weather team reached out to our friends at Leaf Nissan to ask them about building the biggest, baddest storm-chasing truck the state had ever seen, well, they said, sounds like a job for the Nissan Titan. Coming up next on 0 to 60 TV by LeafCars.com, the WRAL Storm Tracker. So what we have here is the ultimate weather station on wheels, the WRAL Storm Tracker by Leaf Nissan. Got my co-host Steve Ewan with me, and we want to welcome very special guest, veteran meteorologist with WRAL, Elizabeth Garner. Thank you for joining us on the show, Elizabeth.
Oh, so glad to be here with you guys and talk about our amazing Storm Tracker. We are so excited about this.
This thing came together just in time, too. Where have you taken the Storm Tracker so far to cover severe weather?
So it came to us about a week before Hurricane Dorian was approaching the coast. So the first place that it went was down to Savannah. Mm-hmm. And Catherine Brown was down with the crew, photographer, engineer, and Catherine in the truck down there tracking the storm. And then they followed it. Once the storm started to come up the South Carolina coast, they followed it all the way up into North Carolina.
Mm-hmm. So it came in handy.
It did, just in time, yes. We have so many other things that we have planned for this truck, though. So not only can we take it out into hurricanes, we'll be tracking strong to severe thunderstorms with it as well.
Can I kick off with asking you a question?
Absolutely.
To this very moment, the most famous thing in radar was the guy on MASH, was radar on MASH. And then I take a look at this radar. Can you just tell us a little bit about how it works and how you use it?
Absolutely. So our Doppler radar, WRAL, has its own Doppler radar, and it sits out in eastern Wake County, and it's 300 feet up into the air with a ball that sits inside that protects it. It's a pretty impressive looking structure. Yeah. And of course, the radar beam goes out into a cloud. It hits the raindrops, and the beam bounces back to the radar, and then it paints a picture of where the rain is and how fast it's moving, and of course, any spin that may be happening.
Yep.
Then we can pull that up, not only in the studio, you see us standing in front of the radar and tracking storms, but we can do it through the truck now as well.
Right.
So we have a radar display, and we can track those storms live from the storm tracker out in the field.
Yeah, fabulous.
So when you guys say, and it's in your promo, that you've taken the weather center and you've put it in the Nissan Titan, the WRAL Storm Tracker, that's what you mean, right?
Exactly. So our plan is to take this out when we have strong thunderstorms coming through, get it near. We don't want to be too close to the storm, of course, but we can get out near where the action is happening.
Yeah. Yeah.
We can pull up the radar and we can track the storms right there. We also have a number of cameras. So if it's not safe to be outside of the vehicle in a storm, we can also use our 360-degree camera on the roof to see what's happening all around us. And as we're driving down the road in a safe way, we can also have a meteorologist or an anchor inside talking about the conditions, and that goes live on the air as well.
All right, so Elizabeth, I see that you've got part of your high-tech gear right here coming out of the bed of the Nissan Titan. What's with the monitor? How do you guys use that with the WRAL Storm Tracker?
So this is really one of the most exciting parts of the truck. So in here, when we get to a location where we're ready to start tracking storms, we can pull this monitor out, and this monitor shows the radar. And from out here in the field, we can actually track the storm. So you see us doing that in the studio. You know, we can pick out a spot. So let's say there's a storm over at Goldsboro. We can put the track on. We can tell people when it's going to be in their neighborhood and at what time and what they need to do. Another thing that's neat is, let's say I was out in the field and Mike Mays was in the studio. He could say, hey, see where the truck is? That's where meteorologist Elizabeth Gardner is in the field. So, you know, whether it's Raleigh, whether it's Durham, whether it's Fayetteville, whatever part of our area we're in, you can see the truck and you can follow it. Even as the truck is driving, we can see it moving down the road. So that will really hit home and really show people where the truck is and where we're tracking the storm from.
Everybody's curious. They want to see the inside of this vehicle, Elizabeth. Can you give us a tour?
Absolutely. So let's say the weather is too bad and you can't be outside tracking a storm. So then you're driving down the road and using the cameras. So up on the roof, We have a 360 degree camera, so I can take this and I can pan around, and you can see there's the fountain all the way up to the front.
And this is why you're driving as well, right?
Exactly. Yes. So there's a driver over here,
yep.
And then in the passenger seat, you can manipulate the camera, and all of this will go live on TV. So then you can switch it, and we have a camera that's inside that's right here. And so if I'm going to be doing a live broadcast, I'll be looking at this camera, and that's what they'll see on the air. And as we go, then I can change it again, and we can see the road right out in front of us. So we have three different cameras, an interior camera, an exterior camera, and then the 360-degree camera on the roof. Pretty neat.
So Elizabeth, good thing that WRAL is using the Nissan Titan, because it's got plenty of room in the back seat, and you guys have a ton of pretty cool looking equipment stuffed in here on the driver's side of the back seat. So do you take someone else along with you when the storm tracker goes out, and are they operating some of this gear?
So when it went out to track Dorian, yes, we had three people in the truck, but you wouldn't necessarily have to. So we'll have a meteorologist or an anchor, and then a photographer who's driving. And that photographer, of course, well trained to use all this. So come on in. So right here, this is what we call a live view, and we can get information. So when we're showing you the Doppler radar on the monitor, that feed is coming in through this machine, which runs over a cellular feed, so just like your cell phone would. And then it also sends our signal back to the station so that they can broadcast it. And then up on the top, this is what runs our satellite, which is on the roof.
Now, Elizabeth, even though the WRAL Storm Tracker, obviously incredibly capable vehicle, the Nissan Titan, you guys, you're not going to drive this thing through, like, you know, floodwaters or high winds or anything, are you?
That's right. So we want to take the vehicle out in the field where we can show people what's happening, where they are, but we're also not going to put it or ourselves in any sort of danger. So we're certainly never going to drive it into floodwater. More people die every year in hurricanes or tropical systems from driving their car into floodwater. So it's not storm surge at the beach. It's not that they're stuck in their houses. It's because they drive their vehicles into water. So we really want to stress that you don't ever want to do that. And of course, we're not going to take it into a place where it's dangerous with high winds either. So we're going to be safe with it, but we just want to use it as a tool to go out and show people, you know, what's happening where they are, what's happened after the storm has moved through, and how they're recovering.
Excellent.
Oh, wonderful. Elizabeth, from everybody at Leaf Nissan, let me thank you for today, for the tour. We're going to be looking out for reports from this beast, and we know that it's going to make people safer, and for that, our gratitude.
Well, thank you to Leaf Nissan as well for making this possible for us, too. We're excited about it.
Great.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
Welcome.
On the next 0 to 60 TV by LeithCars.com, we go from Storm Tracker to Rocky Ridge when we take you on a tour of a custom-built Nissan Titan XD from Leith Nissan.